Hello and thanks for watching my video. Today I'm going to do an unboxing and kind of a quickie review of my new Lenovo ThinkPad T560. Is it still a good idea in 2023? I mean, it's kind of an old computer. This one's actually a refurbished unit from an eBay vendor. This is not a commercial for this vendor. I don't know them. They don't know me. They're not paying me. It's just who I bought it from. It seemed like a pretty good deal. 166 bucks, free shipping, plus tax. Pretty good experience. I ordered the thing on Saturday and then I received it on Wednesday, so 3 business days. So I can't complain about the speed of the shipping. And the carton arrived in good condition. That's Harry the Tux. Thanks, Harry. I wonder if this invalidates my warranty from the vendor. But anyway, Harry approved of the packing job as well. Thanks for that, Harry. So let's get to the unboxing part. There's Harry again. I guess he's going to insert himself into the video. So step one, remove the cat. And as you can see, the carton is in good shape. It doesn't seem to be beat up in shipping or anything. So let's get to it. Little razor knife action. And the suspense is building. Go. So you're seeing it for the first time right along with me. I haven't been in this thing yet, so we are going to find out together what it looks like. There's the battery charger. It appears to be in good condition. Let's see if it's genuine Lenovo or if it's aftermarket. Nope, it is a Lenovo, the real deal, so it's not a not an aftermarket copy. Well, good. And we're also joined by Bella the sheepdog in the upper left corner. So she's crashing my video as well. Thanks, Bella. Right, there appear to be some documents in here. Man, this thing is tight. I can't get the computer out. That is frog ass tight. Woo! Alright. Finally. It's yielding. Whoever packed this thing really didn't want it to get broken, huh? And the lid appears to be in good condition. I don't see any scratches or scuffs or anything. Maybe just some fingerprints. Probably mine. Oh, Harry's back. I'm looking for cracked plastic because a lot of times these, used computers will be cracked around the ports and on the edges. I don't see any cracks on this one. It looks good. Here's the underside. It's actually got the little rubber feet on it. None of the feet are missing. And let's see what kind of battery I got. I wish I had a third hand to get this battery off of here. Come on. I wonder if it's a real Lenovo battery. It is. It's a Lenovo brand battery, not an aftermarket. So that's good. And the battery compartment is clean. I don't see any corrosion or anything. Good deal. And of course, these things are subject to cracks on the hinge line. I don't see any. The hinges are nice and tight. The lid so far is staying where I put it. So no worn out friction on the hinges. That's good. Good hinge tension. The keyboard appears to be in good shape. Maybe a little bit shiny from use, but that's kind of normal. The trackpad doesn't even have a shiny spot. It's got tactile buttons. Lenovo is kind of famous for their keys. It's got the little track point thing. Some people love that thing. I don't use it much. So yeah, good tension on the hinges. It's not worn out at all. So that's good. So far, so good for 166 bucks. All right, what else we got? What kind of documentation is in here? I got some kind of postcard from the vendor. All right. What else? Looks like a packing list. Very exciting, huh? Packing list. Yeah, that's all it is. Anything else? Oh yeah, they got this thing on the back of the packing list. Sanitized with software, cosmetic description, so on. I think the cosmetics are pretty good. All right, the moment of truth, folks. Will it post? Oh, this is suspenseful. What's going to happen? Did I buy a brick? Oh, we got Lenovo. We got post. And there we go. We got the string of pearls. And we're waiting. And we're waiting. Yep, more string of pearls. The usual Windows thing. This thing has a SSD in it, allegedly, so I would think it would boot a little faster. Just a moment, yeah. A long moment. So this might be a clean install where I have to set it up and all that stuff. Let's see. Yep, out-of-box experience. I'm not going to make you wait around for this, folks. Setup is boring, so I'm going to take a edit here. All right, I'm back. I went through the setup thing. This might take several minutes. Yeah, you got that right. Windows. So that was another edit. Almost there, and there we go. Finally, we got a desktop. Good deal. So let's see what I paid for. I'll do the system thing. And see if I got what the ad said I got. So it appears to be an i7 processor, which it was supposed to be, 6th generation, and Windows 10 Pro, that's correct, 8 gigabytes of RAM, that's right. So so far, I am not sensing a ripoff here. The what I got, according to this system app, seems to be in agreement with the eBay ad, so that's good. So there's my specifications. All right, that's enough of that. Let's give it a video and audio test. So we'll go to display settings. ...1920 by 1080, yeah. This is a pretty nice looking display, folks. Look at these colors. Is this an IPS? This must be an IPS display. And there is a, I just got a tropical fish video just to give it a, you know, quick video checkup. And I don't know, I think it looks pretty nice for an old computer. And Lenovos are not, you know, famous. These old Lenovo T-Series are not famous for having great panels on them. They're kind of, you know, for work, not for fun. But this one looks really nice. It's got nice saturation. Oh, it's got a little hitch in it there. But I mean, it's Edge browser. What do you expect? But so far, I'm very satisfied with this display. I don't see any dead spots or hot pixels or anything. And the colors are well saturated. The audio is, well, you can hear it. It's laptop audio. I mean, it's not bad. I also have a T530, and the audio sounds better than the T530, so. So that was the, my definitive YouTube test. So I'm pretty satisfied with this thing. I think I got my money's worth. So, thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll probably do another video when I'm going to add some upgrades to this thing. I want a bigger hard drive. I got a terabyte solid state drive, and I'm probably going to upgrade the RAM from 8 gigabytes to 16 gigabytes. So if I make a video of that, I'll post up, you know, a part two to this thing. So that is my video. Thanks for watching, and hope you enjoyed it.